Hi, artists. Today we're learning about the artist Leonardo da Vinci. Leonardo da Vinci was not only an artist, but he was an Italian, and he was an inventor who was also known as an engineer, a scientist, a theorist, a sculptor, and an architect. And you may know him for the painting I have in my classroom of the Mona Lisa. He painted that as well. Being that he was an inventor with many sketchbooks, he was the first person to draw a helicopter, a tank, and even a robot. So today, what you're going to do is you're going to be like Leonardo da Vinci, and you're going to design your own robot. So let's take a look at some of his artwork before we get started. Okay, so I have my paper ready. So we're gonna think about how would you design your own robot? We're gonna use shapes, we're going to use pattern if you want to, and really function. So think about if you were able to design a robot that maybe would live in your house or would help you with things, what would you want? What would it look like, right? Thinking about colors too, and function. So I'm gonna start off with I'm gonna make my robot in the center. So my robot's going to have a rectangle head. Okay, I'm gonna use some circles for his eyes. Now, oh, let me tell you something before I continue. I don't know if some of you are watching me on mute, but do not copy me. I want you to use your own imagination and your own design. I'm just giving you a sample of what you can do. You can use my idea and make it your own somehow, but your artwork should not look exactly like mine. Okay, I'm going to give my robot a mouth, because who knows, maybe he'll need to play a DVD for me and open his mouth and I can put it in there, right? He's gonna need some ears, so I'm gonna use half of a circle here and there. Rectangle, notice how I'm putting all these shapes together. And just gonna put these random shapes on the top. Another half a circle, and another half a circle, and another one of these. He's got a lot of antenna so that he can play some music with the DVD CD player. I'm gonna give him a square body, or her, to him, her. Put some lines for the neck. And then think about, well, maybe it would be convenient for my robot to have an area where he could microwave my food if I get hungry, right? Think about function, right? So this would be my microwave. Put a little dial here, which is where the time would go. Give it a little bit of a design. Put some zigzag lines for just for a design, a little bit of a pattern with that. And maybe over here will be dials for something else. Who knows? Maybe it's for volume. Maybe it's for communicating with other people. He needs some arms, or she. So I'm gonna just draw like this. And I like those cranes that you see in those game machines. That's pretty cool for his hands. Same thing on the other side, rectangle here. And I'm just doing a line out and down, out and down, out and down, up and down. Okay, give him a little bit of a shape there, and here could be for something else. Again, what is your robot's function, right? What are you having the robot there for? I'm just giving you some ideas, but you should not be copying me. You should be doing your own design. Maybe I'll put lines here, right? So now my robot is designed and finished, and it's got a couple of different functions here, and I'm going to add some color, and I'll be back in a second. So you could start drawing yours, and start adding some color as well. And there you have it. So I didn't add a background because this drawing is more about designing my robot, so I want my robot to be the focus. You can color your background one color that you did not use if you want to, but this is more about the design and the function of what your robot is. So now you are like Leonardo da Vinci and you have designed your own robot. Don't forget to send me a picture for your grade. I can't wait to see it. Bye.